I'm in the middle of an African desert, preparing to trek alone into the hottest place on the planet in search of my mysterious target.
Morning. It's 4 a.m. and I'm just loading up the camels.
For the next 3 days, I'm going to be entirely on my own, so I'll rely heavily on my new four-legged friends.
Gone with the one-eyed camel, Cho, and this, which is the next most placid of the camels, most obedient. A couple of them are a bit feisty. Seems absolutely no point taking him.
I've called him Cho after my old friend who walked the length of the Amazon with me. He needs to be reliable because, for the first time on this trip, I'm trusting my camels to carry my water and my equipment.
I'm going to put that pack on the camel and carry a little day set just with the spare water in it, just in case I lose the camels, which I don't intend on doing.
From this point on, I'm entirely on my own. If things go wrong, there's nobody else to blame.
Tom, cheers, mate.
Good luck, Ed.
Thank you. Probably need it. Okay, I'll see you in 3 days.
Yeah, see you in three days. Hope it goes well.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, I'm off. Me and my camels. From here, I'm just gonna cut down through the village and head on a compass bearing straight towards the place that I've got marked in the GPS as the black dots. I'm also setting off in the dark. I'm also doing a route that I've never done before. And I'm also... I'm pretty apprehensive, I have to say.
I'm carrying supplies for 3 days. That gives me a day and a half to try and find the target before I'll need to turn back.
Reassuringly, for someone who's just about to walk into the middle of the desert, I've got my first bout of very runny diarrhea. I literally could poo through the eye of a needle. Not letting my guard down. I don't want to convey that I'm not fully alert, because I most definitely am. However, I'm out on the flats. I'm walking through the desert. I've got my camels. It's working. It's better.
After a couple of hours, I've left all signs of life behind, and I'm making good progress into this alien landscape.
I have to admit to a massive feeling of freedom out here. You know, absolutely nothing surrounding me whatsoever, except desert. I need to be really careful about dehydration now. I do need to be cautious now. Come on, mate.
It's 7 a.m. and the temperature's already hit 42 degrees. With no chance of any respite from the blazing sun.
It's only about 2 months ago that a geologist from Addis Ababa came in here to this specific area in the desert, overheated, organs failed, and died. This is a landscape, an environment not to be messed with, really. Hence, not underestimating the conditions and hence carrying all the kit and equipment that I've got with me. In many ways, it's very, very...
I think the heat is already affecting my mind. It takes me vital seconds to register what I've seen.
Me, look.
And it's not good.
Where are the camels over there? Oh my God. I hadn't even noticed it had come undone. Okay, that tactic didn't work. As I was running towards it, it scared it. And now the blind camel is walking away. Oh! No, Chuck.
The temperature is hitting over 50 degrees, and it's still only morning. Whoa. I'm now in real danger of losing both camels and everything they're carrying.
Easy.
And in this heat, that could be fatal.
Calm. It's okay. It's okay. And I've got you. Okay. I've one camel. Now, I go a fast but steady pace to the next camel and don't scare it. I think they sense panic, so I just need to calm myself down. Sugar, it's time to run.
For another hour or more, I chase after the runaway camel. I'm sweating buckets, I'm seriously dehydrated, and getting somewhat delirious. But then, just in time, the camel stops walking away, and I'm back in control.
Whoever said walking with camels in the desert is easy was lying.